Hello everyone, welcome back to Vintage. Last week I was talking about Hagseed, which is Margaret Atwood's new novel, part of the Hogarth Shakespeare series. Loads of amazing comments from people last week. Margaret Atwood is the kind of author who does get people very excited, and I think that combination of her and The Tempest is just a wonderful thing. Since making that video, I have been to the South Bank, where there was a digital art installation thing there, which used Hagseed as an inspiration and in fact sort of allowed you to interact with this camera to bring her words to life. And in fact, she went in there and did it herself. And if you haven't seen the video of Margaret Atwood dancing to make her own words come alive, then you haven't lived. So I'm going to include a link below to that video because it's just a beautiful thing. You have to see it. She is a legend, absolutely amazing woman, so full of life, and yeah, just watch the video. Anyway, I had two copies of Hagseed to give away, and the lucky people winning those are Tina Alex and Ian Calloway, so congratulations to both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video. Send me your postal addresses and I'll get copies off to you as soon as I can. This week, we're talking about Virginia Woolf. Who's afraid of Virginia Woolf? Are you afraid of Virginia Woolf? I was a little bit afraid of Virginia Woolf because she's one of those authors that I hadn't read, and then I still hadn't read, and then I still hadn't read, and then it was sort of getting a bit awkward because I hadn't read Virginia Woolf, and I wondered whether I ever would. Then luckily, Vintage Classics came along and created a new set of six Woolf titles with these amazing, beautiful designs by Anamaya Metsola. That name comes with a pronunciation warning. I'm not quite sure how close I got there. But anyway, the designs are amazing. They've got these French flapped. The design continues inside. They are just stunning. I'm holding up Mrs. Dalloway here because this is the copy that I read. But there are six titles and they look like this. Yeah, pretty good, eh? They really are stunningly beautiful. And that's why you're all going to be very excited, because instead of just giving away a couple of copies of Mr. Dalloway, I'm going to give away one complete set this week. You can win all six books, which has got to be enough to get quite a lot of book squee in the comments down below. Make sure you are subscribed and leave a comment below if you want to be entered into that draw. But first of all, let's talk a little bit about Mrs. Dalloway. As I said, a book that I hadn't read before, an author I hadn't read before, and I wasn't quite sure what to expect. But immediately with this book, you are so involved and engaged, because what she does brilliantly, and I'm going to sound like a complete idiot probably to lots of you who may have studied Virginia Woolf, but it's a bit of a revelation for me. She does this sort of thing where the narrative switches from one person to another. It's a bit like sort of you're a floating soul that's sort of going around London on this day when Clarissa Dalloway, of the title, is preparing for a party in the evening, and you see it from her point of view, but you also see it from other people's point of view. And the deftness with which she moves that narration in scenes, particularly in scenes which are sort of outside on the street and something's happening and people's attention is, you know, going from one thing to another, and then your attention as the reader is taken from one consciousness to another. It's so brilliantly done. It's just amazing. And I think my main thing from reading this book and from reading Virginia Woolf is that we talk a lot, there's a lot of people nowadays writing books and they're talking about experimentation with form and how sort of standard narrative is dead and all that kind of stuff. And you kind of think, actually, she was doing this a long time ago, guys. So she was experimenting with form a long time ago, along with, of course, other members of her group and James Joyce and people like that. You know, these are the real modernizers of the English novel. And in fact, a lot of what comes after that is really just sort of copying that same idea. And so it was really nice to read one of the originators of that sort of shifting narrative, not quite stream of consciousness, but not far off. And finding just how effective that is as a way of telling a story. So we see Clarissa Dalloway, we see her husband, sort of peripheral figure, but we get a big sort of idea about her marriage, and in particular her previous relationship, on sort of non-relationship with a man called Peter Walsh. We also learn about the backstory of a man called Septimus, who is somebody who had served in the war and lost a friend and has been suffering with what we would probably now call post-traumatic stress disorder, probably not even called shell shock, but from what he's suffering in the book, but really struggling with his health, and his mental health in particular. And that is brilliantly done. It's very sympathetically done. You get a real sense of his confusion and depression, and that sort of builds up to almost to the denouement of the book, which of course is Mrs. Dalloway's party itself. And I don't know if I want to say too much more, because otherwise, A, I'll sound like an idiot to those of you who know this book far better than I do, and B, I don't want to sort of give it away. It's not really about the plot, as I say. It's sort of about enjoying the narrative experience. But I loved it. It was so easy to read. It was a real joy to read. And I'm wondering where I go next with Virginia Woolf, because I get the impression that a lot of her books are quite different, sort of my understanding of what To the Lighthouse and Orlando will be about. But I know that I think Mrs. Dalloway is a really, really good place to start if you've never read Virginia Woolf before. If you haven't read Virginia Woolf before and you would like a bit more advice, there is a great article on our website written by Eric Carl Anderson, known as Lonesome Reader here on YouTube. And he's given a sort of little précis for each book to give you a guide as to which one might be the best place for you to start in as a reader if you've never read Virginia Woolf before, or indeed if you have and you're wondering where to go next. It's a really nice article and it gives you a chance to ogle at the books once more. So I'll put a link for that down in the description below. Do have a read of that. And as I say, if you want to win a complete set, all six books, which I think is a pretty exciting prize, make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment below, and I will pick one lucky winner next week. There we go. That's all for this week. I will see you next week. Take care.